Hey, welcome to the Crazy Hat Chemist. So here we go. Stoichiometry and dimensional analysis still is our unit. And today we're going to be doing 8.4, which is stoichiometry and balanced equations. The fourth video on balanced equations with stoichiometry. So here we go. Bam! So 1.24 grams of sodium metal is added to a test tube of sulfuric acid. What is the volume in liters of gas produced under STP conditions? So we first got to get the formula for sulfuric acid. Remember your acid nomenclature. So you might need to go back and watch that video on acid nomenclature. We always have our flow chart handy, so we can refer to that all the time. So we first got to get the formula for sulfuric acid. Acids always have a hydrogen, and sulfuric is coming from sulfate. So we got to write down the sulfate ion. So here is hydrogen with a 1 plus charge because it's in group 1, and sulfate, that's a polyatomic ion. You're going to take the 1 plus and the 2 minus. Absolute value of those numbers, flip the numbers, bring them down, you're going to get H2SO4. And then it's sodium metal. And it's sodium metal, so that has a zero charge to it because it's an element in its standard state. And this is what we get for our two reactants. Sodium metal is a solid, sulfuric acid is aqueous, that means it's in solution. So now you need to ask yourself, what type of equation is this exactly? That's right, it is a single displacement type of reaction. So what I want you to do now is I want you to pause the video right now, and then I want you to spend that time while it's being paused to write down the two products. It's a single displacement reaction. Think about what that sodium is going to displace, and then think about what the compound is going to be. If you need to, review those units on those videos on chemical reactions. So I want you to write the products, then I want you to balance it. And then unpause the video, and then here we go! Bam! So here is our balanced chemical equation. That is, the sodium metal is displacing the hydrogen. Hydrogen is by itself, and that's a diatomic, and that's H2, and that's a gas. And then I have Na2SO4, because the charge on the sodium is a 1 plus, the charge on the sulfate is a 2 minus. I flip the numbers, bring it down, and that's why it's Na2SO4 parentheses and a 1, but we don't write the parentheses when it's a 1. So now I need to reread the question and figure out what I actually have. And so I have grams of sodium metal, and that's 1.24 grams of sodium metal. And what do I want to get? I want to get to a volume in liters of the gas produced, and that is hydrogen gas. So I'm going to go from sodium metal to hydrogen gas. Now I'm going to look at my flow chart and figure out what I have. I have 1.24 grams. That is a mass. I am going to go from grams of sodium to moles of sodium. That's using the molar mass. It's on your periodic table right there. And then I'm going to use a mole ratio to go from the moles of sodium to moles of hydrogen. And then from the moles of hydrogen, then I am going to go to volume of hydrogen because it's under STP conditions. That is, STP is standard temperature and pressure. And recall that one mole is equal to 22.414 liters at STP only. So what I want you to do right now is I want you to pause the video, do that monorail of stoichiometry, make sure you have number, units, formula for every single step, cancel out your units and formula, and then get your answer. Look at the number of significant figures that you have, and round your answer correctly too. So pause that video, and then here we go, boom! We're going to keep on going. So 1.24 grams of sodium, we're going to cancel out the units and the units for grams of sodium right there. We always have to use a mole ratio, and that is here in the blue rectangular box. Those are the balanced stoichiometric coefficients from our, or the stoichiometric coefficients from our balanced equation. Okay, our grams cancels out, our moles cancels out of sodium, and our moles cancels out of hydrogen gas. And then we're going to look at significant figures. How many significant figures in 1.24? That's going to be 3. How many significant figures in the mole, in the one in front of the mole? That's infinite. And 1, and that's infinite. 22.414. We could actually have a larger number here, but this is what we're using. That's 5. In the 22.99, the molar mass of sodium that's on your periodic table, we have 4 right there. And then an infinite and an infinite. So the fewest number of significant figures that we have on this problem is 3. So we're going to round our answer to 3 significant figures. But first, we're going to do the math here. And this is the number that's coming out of your calculator. That's 0.60446. And I'm going to round to three significant figures. So therefore, I'm going to be using this 4 here for rounding. So I'm going to truncate the number since that is less than 5. So here's my number, units, and formula correctly rounded. That's 0.604 liters of hydrogen gas. You could have written this as 6.04 times 10 to the negative 1 liters of hydrogen gas. That would have been fine. But I do have a number, units, and a formula for every single step along this problem, as well as my answer. I hope that problem saw you well, and we were having such a fun time here with some crazy hat. So keep on going and review your nomenclature, chemical reactions, and keep on going. See you then. Bye.